wanna do is maybe paint. I'm gonna draw really quickly sort of where my horizon's gonna be. Probably about maybe just about 2/3. Maybe just a little bit more than 2/3 of the way down. It's gonna be my horizon line for this painting. So we'll have some mountains back here. We have a really large mountain. Something like that. So, have our mountains, have our lake, have a shoreline curving over, have some fields, some hills, and then in the foreground, we'll bring in our large Hogwarts castle. So, that's kind of what we're going to be looking at doing on this painting. So here in the background, I want to paint in some cloud coverage. And I might just scrub this in. I'm looking at this right now. I might take my. This is my number 10 bristle brush. So I'm going to start down here with a nice light color, a little white, a little yellow, put a little orange in that, kind of create a bit of a gold color. Thank you. we're going to start working now on a little bit of some sunburst. We're going to bring in some sunburst coming through the clouds here. I might want to add a little bit more fog into our tree line here. So just going to grab our our filbert brush and we'll come into a little white, a little yellow. And maybe coming in through here. Just start adding some glow. not really an impressionist painter. I like impressionism, especially if done right. I like more reality, but every painting starts off impressionistic. And then as you start layering on more detail, it becomes more, less of an impressionistic, more of a realism, which is sort of what I try to achieve somewhere in the middle, so to speak. All right, so now that we've got that laid in, what I want to focus on is here in the corner, we're gonna have another body of land. So I'll take my little angle brush here and go into my green, sienna, purple, and a little white to opaque that. Some covering here in the corner. Kind of a dark covering. Pretty dark in the bottom, and then as I work my way up, it'll start to lighten. Thank you. This morning, continuing on our painting here, I have drawn in some guides on the on some of these towers here. Drawn in a little bit of some windows, and I did add in a little bit of a highlight in some of the sections here. And I'm going to continue with that. I'm just taking just a gray color here that I had mixed, and I used black, white, some blue, and came up with this little grayish mixture. And I was just going to add a little bit more highlights right in here. And maybe the indication of a little window. So these are just really simple little lines. There's nothing really special here. I am kind of highlighting around some of the outside of the building, kind of around the edges. So, nothing too wild here. So just a nice little outline. Lightness up a little bit. So let's have a nice sunlit section on that. Okay, so I'm getting a little closer here, so I'm going to have to put this in my lap because there's just a lot of detail work, and I've drawn in the windows here on the towers. I also went back. I decided grab my brush here. So I decided to change out my little highlighting here. So I'm going to come back in here, some of my gray mixture, and then coming through here, I want to bring in my highlight. Make sure it's just a little bit thinner. And we'll have little turrets or something going on right here. So I'm just making little humps. And some interest here. These are getting sunlit on the front of the building. So just bringing some of that in now. I want to do, I'm going to bring in a little darker gray just to darken it up even more. Just want to add a little ridge there. A little shadowing. Okay. This is going to be a little challenging with recording because I've got to keep this in my lap and be able to do some of my highlighting. So right in here, I've made sort of white and some umber. A little purple. Have a little mixture here that when I come in here on this window, add a little more white to get this a little more opaque. Shows up better. Okay, so I just need to draw in this part of the little roof that's getting some sunlight. Hitting it. Thank you.
Thank you.
maybe a little more brightness to this sunrise here. And in order to achieve that, and I wanted to get that in before I really started working on this large spire here. So I'd like to just go ahead and get it a little brighter, and then I can always reblock in the spire. So I'll probably end up covering some of what I've already put here, but that's okay. So I'm going to come into my little bright yellow mixture that I've made here, kind of my gold mixture, and add a little bit more white to it to really brighten it up and making it pretty thick. I really like to bring that in kind of back here. What I've done now is I've come in here and kind of reblocked in this particular spire here, and I lightly with my charcoal pencil made some lines for guides for me on this, because this rooftop is going to have certain I don't know, just certain divisions broken into it. So each division each division will have kind of a different highlighted color from darker to lighter as it turns toward the sun. And before I kind of jump into that, I also added, just to let you know, I added a little bit of highlight in the tree line back here with just a little light green color, as well as kind of did a very slight highlight on the trees right here. And what I did for that was I just took kind of a yellow, white, green, and for example on these trees here, just kind of on the right side, added a little highlighted color just to give the impression that the sun's slightly hitting those trees there. So what I want to do before I jump into this particular spire though is I wanted to take my my small angle brush here. I'd like to bring in a little bit more yellow into the water. And so to do that, I just have this little pile of yellow that I made here. And it's gonna be a little pale. Just add a little white to that. Make it a little more pale. And then through here, I just wanted to kind of just bring a simple little line of yellow right here. Thank you. So I have my brushes laid out for me here, and I'm gonna go ahead and start working on the lighter portion of this. So it's a fairly thin line that we're gonna run across. I think the best way to handle that is to take my thin angle brush. And we've already laid out our dark underpainting on here. So I'm gonna kind of come in with a lighter gray tone, and I've already got a little pile of gray that I've sort of made here. So I'm just gonna add some white to that gray tone mixture. And let's see if this is going to be the right color. So just a thin, light thin line. I'm looking at that, I don't think it's quite light enough, so I'm coming with more white. I'm really trying to highlight that even more. As I'm angling down, my line's going to get a little thicker. So I'm going to kind of turn my brush inward as it comes in, so I can achieve a nice thicker line. Okay. I'm going to go to a little darker gray with premixed here. And these three spires are going to cast a bit of a shadow down here, but I'm going to add the shadow afterward. I think it's going to be better for me to just bring in our variation of different tones here. And on this one, I'm going to leave a little gap here with my underpainting so that there's a bit of a line that's showing through, because I want to kind of show there's a bit of a ridge there. So a little bit lighter tone. lining the sides here and then here in the middle. So I'm gonna hand draw those in and I'll be right. So I took a moment with my charcoal pencil and outlined where I wanted to have my little windows. So now we're gonna come back through, and this is gonna require a good bit of detail work. So I think I'm gonna move to my little round, I'm not even sure what number this is. I think this is a number 2 round brush. And it's gonna help me to get in here and really create my small little windows. So these are gonna be kind of in shadow, and we'll be casting a tiny shadow here on this side of the building. So I'm gonna go into my gray mixture here, and I'm gonna go ahead and kind of make a little pile. There's a little blue, a purple, and a little black. Let's see if we can get the right tone. Okay. And from this, I'll see if I can get the right tone here. That's not too bad. I think the color's just about where I wanted it to be. Thank you. I've now come through here and created a chalk outline of these thestrals. So just a really basic, just a little, turn this volume down. Just a really basic outline, silhouette of these thestrals. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start here in the background with my furthest, most distant thestral. I'll be taking my number two brush, and thestrals are creatures that are the color of midnight, so they're very dark. So what I think I'm going to mainly do is go with sort of a dark gray, blackish blue color, more on the dark grayish, almost maybe not quite black, but a certain really, really dark charcoal gray color, and I'll use blue for the highlights. So way back in the distance, we're not going to see a lot going on here, but I do want to come down into my gray mixture that I've created down here, and I think that matter of fact, I think because this one's so distant, I'm going to go with using my my script liner brush again, and going into this gray mixture that I've created. So this guy is really distant. that kind of helps to show now what we've got going on here. And that's going to bring us to our big guy now. And so we're going to have a little more detail. This one's a lot closer. What we're going to do, I'm going to use my little angle brush here. And we're going to go into our dark charcoal color. So I'm going to bring in more black, purple, white, and we're gonna block in our big guy now. Okay. Foot. All right. And the rider's head, I'm going to go into some pure black. This is going to be Harry's head, so we want to make sure that we have Harry on this thestral. So his hair is kind of blowing in the wind. Right, so we've got some hair, and then dark skin tone, kind of get that blocked in. His nose. His cheek and his chin. So we can sort of see. that's about the right color that I want to achieve this. So we'll come in here and we'll gently start rolling this color into the wings. Here we'll do it again. We'll have some glow from the sky. And that rising sun coming through early morning. That kind of starts the process. We're going to do that down here too. So we'll have a nice little glow. We'll bring up into those little bat wings. Dragon wings. You just gently roll this. Okay. So we're looking here at the finished version of our Harry Potter painting, Thestrals Flying Over Hogwarts Castle. So we just completed putting in all the thestrals. Pretty simple. I'll give you a quick overview. So we've got the mountains. We started in the background. Brought in the cloud coverage, all the highlights, the reflections in the water, some of the water lines, and the trees. Brought in a bunch of sun rays and mist. Give it that early morning mist. We brought in a couple of the towers here at Hogwarts, and then we had our large tower with all of our spires, all of our windows here, and of course we had our little thestrals that we painted in. These are all of Harry and his friends flying, and then of course we have Harry on his thestral. Pan out here. So this is this is our finished version. This is done in acrylic. It's a 16 by 20 canvas board. This has been a commission painting for a Harry Potter fan. And it was a fun project. I hope you enjoyed the video, and look forward to doing some more in the future. Thanks, everyone.